I don't know if what Ryan told me was true, because it didn't make sense.
But he told me.
He told you what?
That we've been kidnapped because he...
Hey, guys.
Rusty. Hey.
Mom is at the morgue with Lieutenant Tao and Lieutenant Provenza. They're trying to close out this St. Joseph's 3 case that's been all over the news.
Yeah, so you guys might have to grab some dinner without us.
Oh, my. We still are having a wedding rehearsal tomorrow night, yes?
Yeah, well, that's that's kind of up in the air a little, too. We might have to work the vows around the investigation somehow.
Well, I thought, didn't the doctor tell Mom that she should cut back?
Well, only when she's tired and the medication he gave her is working very well. And, well, you know, she's lived a very good life. And it's not like she has a lot of bad habits she has to kick.
Right now?
Well, maybe we should have dinner in tonight.
Sure, yeah. Hey, while we're here, use us to ease up on Mom's stress any way we can.
Besides suicide, I have two.
It looked like someone tried hard to revive him. And the other injury is a skull fracture just beneath the hairline.
You could see it
on the x-rays. Marks are a lot alike.
Well, we've got a problem. FBI agents Vega and Faye are back. Wait to hear the lame-ass excuse these two come up with.
I don't normally say this to local law enforcement, but on behalf of the FBI, I apologize. With this amount of money and the implications both here and across the border, we saw this as a for-ransom kidnapping.
We've read the suicide note written by Dr. Garza. And while technically the kids were abducted, the $1 million is not part of that.
And?
Again, we were wrong. And we apologize.
Now I have heard everything.
It's based on
evidence of an altercation.
Evidence. I want to see it.
Our joint task force has concluded.
To make dinner for you. The whole idea was...
She's taking her meds. She feels a lot better. Grab a chair. The adults have this. We really do.
Fine, fine. Just from now on, please. We do not want you taking care of us. We want to take care of you.
But if I can't do the things that make life worth living, why be here at all? No, come on. Let's try and talk about normalcy.
Checks at the florist and the caterer, and no matter what happens, Friday night we're having a rehearsal dinner, and then Saturday at 2 p.m., assuming you guys haven't all been excommunicated.
Almost done.
Seriously?
Yes, I've got two doctors coming tomorrow to check the throats of Miguel and Ryan if they find what I think is fine.
Two doctors?
Yes, well, I can't make an arrest based on a physical exam without a second opinion. Don't you think, Andy?
Well, yeah, I mean, because we're so close to the finish line, just a couple of questions to answer.
What kind of questions?
I've been praying with you and your family for the last 22 years. And it's as that person I ask. How are you feeling?
Almost. Overwhelmed, not by work or by the wedding, but they turned to help me. They express their fears to you.
Christ is here to take those fears away from them and to relieve you also of all your worries.
My worries. There's a lot to let go of.
Which is the purpose of faith. We turn over that which is beyond our control. And take comfort in the fact that no matter what else happens, God's will be done.
Of course. This will be done.
Assuming you still want me to marry you.
Of course, Father. That's not the issue at all.
Look, you can have 2 more hours. We'll wait and drive.
Okay, what about the rehearsal?
I'll take care of the kids if you'll help Dr. Redmond set up. Thank you.
The rehearsal just for a second.
All that is required of me for this rehearsal is to show up, look great, and walk down the aisle. I don't need to practice that.
But Mom,
I said I don't need to practice walking down the aisle. Now, if you're my chief mason, we're about to make an arrest. Are you sure?
Positive.
But you won't mind us getting a second opinion, will you?
Hi, Dr. Morales.
What's going on? I did an examination. Why did you have me look again?
To catch you in a lie, doctor.
Yeah.
Or speak during this. But look at how many families you've destroyed.
Use the back of Ryan's throat and the back of Miguel's. The marks are fainter, naturally, but still visible. Matching up to the mark on Lucas and
Dr. Garza's throat.
Wait before you answer that.
You have the right to remain silent.
Oh, but don't worry. Sarah already admitted to the affair.
That's me. No, she did not.
Oh, yes, she did, sir.
So,
check the boarding. You will see my name is
not
Damien Edlow, who walked like he had not just had knee surgery. No, doctor, we won't find your name, but we found you.
This guy.
Really? Why?
Yeah.